Here's the Linux operating system that I built. It's a Linux operating system. There's a book on the internet called Linux from Scratch. You can download that book, and it gives you instructions on how to build your own Linux operating system. It's very, very educational, learning how to do that, how everything works. And the original intent of Linux from Scratch was not to replace your desktop, but was designed for a learning experience. But there are some of us who have used that and also used the book called Beyond Linux from Scratch and actually built our own and like better than any other distro out there. And this is the one that I built. This is my, I like using a scrollable desktop. So I got plenty of space. Now this particular, it's not my actual desktop. I have even more than this. But I'm actually recording right now on my clone. Well, actually, I have several clones of it, but this is actually the other user on the same computer. But anyway, same difference. I have it set to automatically open up this logging so I can see what's going on when I insert a memory stick or whatever. Makes it easier for checking things out. This is my recording software I got running. Just a little, real simple software that I wrote to record the desktop. But anyway, I've got a variety of file managers and more than that really, but I got Mate installed. I like Mate Desktop, so I got the Mate Desktop installed. This is good. This is good for looking at your hardware. Some terminals, Bluefish Editor, really good, highly recommendable editor, especially for editing code and such. Hex Editor, text editors. Got GSmart for looking at your hard drive. The hard drive has its own computer, and it's able to detect problems long before you'll ever know there's a problem. And so you can check using this software, and it'll give you information. So it will show, this is nice. In Windows, you're limited with whatever. But anyway, with Linux, you have freedom to do whatever you want. That's really the biggest advantage of Linux, is the freedom to do what you want. Have an operating system that works the way you want it to work. So here you can see my drives. Information, attributes. This is the key part you want to look at here. If anything was bad here, it would be highlighted in red. Raw error rates, spin up time, starts. Relocated sector count. When your hard drive starts getting old and getting bad sectors, you know, this number will start coming up. You get a small number in there that's not really growing. Then just keep an eye on it. But if that starts growing, you better get a new hard drive and back it up, unless you don't care about your data. Seek error rate. But anyway, then you can even run tests. You can go over here and tell it to do a short test, which takes 60 seconds. Or on this 2 terabyte hard drive, the extended test would take 6 hours and 18 minutes. But these tests, the hard drive has its own computer. It is doing its own testing. It's not your the computer is not actually doing it. It's the hard drive that's doing its own test and giving you the results. Make calculator, GNU image manipulator. This is good software. They got it for Windows as well, so if you don't have Linux, you can use this in Windows. Same thing with VLC media player. You should have both of these, whether you got Windows or Linux. Both of these are highly recommendable. CD burning software, Firefox. I got two versions. There's issues that I don't like about the newer versions. So I have the older version I use most of the time. But then on some places I'll end up using the most current version. FileZilla, they've got it for both Windows and Linux for uploading files to your website. Everybody who has a website should have this software. Wireless. This is a little simple thing that gives you an idea of what's going on. I use these clones of this operating system on different computers. And so I go onto a different computer, it's got a different wireless and network cards. So I just click on that, and it tells me wireless is a wireless 6, Ethernet 3 is an Ethernet 3. So I go here, and then change to whichever one I need by looking at this. This is wireless, what? Oh yeah, right, wireless LAN 6. You can see here I got wireless LAN 6. And so I changed this to wireless LAN 6, and now I can connect, or Ethernet. So while I'm using on different computers, this little thing right here makes it nice to quickly see which wireless connection it's using. And screensaver. Click on that, it'll lock your screen. This one's just for settings. Cups printing. I got display information, got power. I got several desktops. Then if you're not familiar with Linux, that's another nice thing about Linux. It's like, imagine having a computer that you have Windows 95, Windows XP, Windows 8, Windows 10, all combined together. And anytime you log on, you can say, well, I want to log on as Windows XP, or I want to log on as Windows 10. With Linux, you have that freedom to log on to different desktops. And I created this little thing here. Opens up different logon. But anyway. VirtualBox. I've got a bunch of operating systems. I've got about over a dozen operating systems running. Not running at the same time. We've got Windows. Even at Windows 3.1, just kicks and giggles, and click on Windows 10.1 will fill the screen. Windows 3.1 will fill the screen. Someone asked me, what version you got? I got Windows 3.1, see? All right. Mouse, keyboard, LibreOffice, and OpenOffice. If you don't have that, those are available on Windows. You don't have to pay Microsoft money. You can get your own office for free. Office software, LibreOffice or OpenOffice. Got the weather, but anyway, this is my operating system. I like it because it works the way I want it to work. There's no updates to crash my computer. Whenever I want to do an update, I do the update myself. Now I'm on one of my clones, and I'm going to demonstrate how I use the install user method to compile some code to install a program. So first as root, I'm going to install. First thing I'm going to install is XFburn. It's a CD software, CD burning software. This one's a real simple one. First thing we'll do is, I like having several open at once, several terminals. Directory sources, and let's see, mwget There's the address. Copy link locations. It's done download the source code for XFBurn. You know, MD5 sums, another sums. Copy. A lot of times, what I do, I just Google it. Google checksum. That's a lot of times easier than. And there it is. So download was good. Next thing is to do an install user, install package, XFBurn. It automatically changes into that directory and is right my configure. Compiling the code right now. And make install. And there it's done. It's installed. That backs it. And let's see. The desktop. Applications. And there it is. And that can then be copied over the desktop. Copy. I like to put it here first, then put it in my desktop. And start it up. Could have started from applications. Didn't have to copy it over. But anywho. And there it is. Okay, that was a real simple one. Next one we'll do is Bluefish. Bluefish at text editor. That one's already installed, but I'm going to install a newer version. This is a, see if it fixes one of the bugs. And since it's just a subvert, I'm just going to do that inside of Bluefish instead of putting in the sources. User, Bluefish user. Now we're inside. Okay, let's run. That's the one I want. There we go. Configure file is not created yet. So we'll create the configure file. I configure. Okay, it's compiling the code now. I'm gonna configure it. And running make. This will compile the code. Now when I run make install, it'll give an error because I'm running this as, I'm installing this as a install user, which is instead of installing it as root, which is typically the way Linux code is installed. But then I have a setup with the program that will fix that. Make install. You see the error. It's a desktop. I mean, not desktop. Data install data hook error. So we'll type no update. No update mine packages. Then there's another error that it'll give, so I'll go ahead and type in that one. What it does is it edits the a file so it doesn't try to do what it cannot do since it's not being installed as root. And it'll run make install. There it is. It's installed. But because I told it not to do those databases, I'll run another terminal as root to update databases. That's just a little program setting that I have that does a number of different databases. Just makes it real simple. Does them all. I have several programs that stop it from doing stuff it can't do so it doesn't error out, and then I just run this afterwards. And it, now we can go over to applications, and we'll see that it's installed. Well, actually, Bluefish is already installed, so we'll click on that. And check the version. And there it is, revision number 8752. So now I can test and see if that one particular bug has been fixed in that revision. And then we can go to exit. We're done installing it. You can see all the users, install users I've got. Because everything I installed, I created a user for by using, that's the method of doing this, the install user method. So there's the XFburn I just installed earlier. Bluefish was already there, so it's up there a little higher up. You can see at the beginning, first programs I had to create. Just slowly build more and more advanced, more and more programs on top of each other to advance the quality of the operating system. And all the programs that go in and everything. An operating system is made up of a lot of programs. Okay, here's one of my clones, my Linux clones that I built. I have multiple clones of the same system. Makes it useful for testing. I'll boot this thing up. And there's your grub boot menu. With Linux, you can choose different kernels. You got a lot of flexibilities. I like having all this text showing up. You can have it set to just do graphics, but I like the text so I can see what's going on. Now the graphics driver has been loaded, so now it's in smaller print. And there's the login screen. Now with Linux, you have a lot of versatility. You can set things up how you want it, choose what you want. So I got Mate Desktop. It's like if you had Windows, Microsoft Windows, and you had Windows XP, Windows 7, Windows 10, all running together, and you could choose when you boot up which one you want, and all your files are there just the same. Here I got Mate Desktop, LXDE, I got GNOME, Openbox. Actually, that one's just some of the system files. Got KDE, got Openbox, XFCE, and another KDE. So log in with Mate. Log files. I like to keep the log files up here so I can see what's going on with the desktop. There's the regular desktop, but I like having my own desktop. It's scrollable. Places, all the stuff here. System. We'll log on the other one. And one of the other ones. So let's go KDE. KDE is pretty popular too. I like Mate the best. KDE takes a little longer to boot up. Got a little more fancy, but to me, I think Mate is more practical. But that's the nice thing about Linux. You can choose. You have the freedom to choose. It's not like Microsoft where you're stuck with what they give you. Yes, screensaver needs updated. I'll do that sometime. There's KDE's set up. This is kind of nice, but feel everything. So I'll log out. LXDE desktop. Pretty good. The LXDE, this desktop's a little simpler than the others. It's easy to build, more trouble free as far as trying to build it. So, that and the XF, both of those are simple. This one's a pretty good desktop though. And you can see that the bar in the bottom is a little different. They have kind of designed them a little. And of course, you can move these things around. You have so much flexibility to be able to move these things around. I have this thing, this design so set up so you can log in. You can be logged in twice in two different at the same time by using a very easy switch back and forth. You can do it in Windows too, but this is a little nicer the way this one works. So it's still running. The other one, so I'm logging first user. Let's go XFCE session. Some people like having theirs on top, the bar. I always move it on the side, or I like to put it on the bottom. But this is a real, very basic, easy to build, but it's not, to me, it's not that nice of a desktop, but it's nice for a fallback to have available. It's not bad. A lot of people like it because it's real simple. It doesn't take up a lot of space on a hard drive. I can switch. I can leave this running. Switch over back to the other. Just switch back and forth very easily just by pressing keys on the keyboard. Back and forth. Here. You can see it's got a little different logout than the other ones do. They're all slightly different. They have their advantages and disadvantages. I personally like Mate the best. And so that's all the desktops that I have installed. There are more you could actually install. You can do just the flexibility of Linux, especially when you build it yourself, is just awesome. This screensaver that keeps complaining about being needing an update. Pretty nice screensaver. I like it. It's got a lot of interesting stuff. I'm gonna lock the screen and show you the screensaver. There's a whole variety of different stuff. We've got one. There's a Pac-Man game playing. Let's see, screensaver. Yeah, elevate. There's one on this screensaver, which I disabled, but it will fool you into thinking that the computer's crashing and it gives all these stupid errors. After a while you start watching, you realize, wait a minute, this is a joke. You're playing games. This one's funny. Cool. Bouncing cow on the screen. Yeah, there's the fake. the fake, that one's actually marked as enabled. Crashing. I'm gonna disable that one. I disabled for my user, but I need to go through and disable any other. That's a little bit cruel. But anyway, enough of the screensavers. So there it is. But anyway, one of the nice things, they've got these boxes here, allows you to switch within the same desktop. So like, for example, this one here, I can move that over. Move to workspace right. And now it's over here. Move it back. Move workspace left. That's over here. Another thing I really like about Maven is, let's say you're trying to, you got two windows open. Let's see, you got another one. Let's say you need a full size, but you want this, you want to type on here, but you want this one up front. You just right click on it, click always on top. And then I click on there. It's still there so I can type. So if I'm trying to read what was written here, I have to read it and type on the screen behind it without this one disappearing. Keeps it always on top. And then I can still minimize if I want to. Bring it back up. And still always on top. And I can undo that always on clock on top. And then click here and it's back to normal again, you can see. This really comes in handy a lot of times, especially if you're trying to type in something that won't let you copy and paste it. And you're trying to type it in, on top, this really is handy. Most desktops don't have that function, but the Mate desktop does.